Well, this is the second season of the DRS, which is the Doubtful Review System, and the Indian T20 League is in its second week now. And so are we on this show, which means that our two batsmen, Akhil Ranade and Arun Gopalakrishnan, are all settled in. They're very well settled. And talking about settled in, I think one team that looks very settled is Bengaluru. And of course, it's been a week about Bengaluru and Particles 100 and so, but there's also a pack Cummins with the fastest 50. Yeah, that too happened. But you're here not for the news. You're here actually for reviews. So why don't we get started? Let's start the Doubtful Review System. Akhil and Arun, welcome back to the show. Did you have any kind of hangover of it when you went back? I'll start with you, Akhil.
Yes, absolutely. Was looking forward to coming back and like having a chat on DRS again. A couple of interesting DRS reviews which didn't go the right way that I wanted last week. So I was looking forward to come and have a chat on the show this time.
Amazing. And what has been the most surprising thing for you in the week gone by?
A week gone by has been the inability of batsmen to score a lot of runs in Chennai. It's like we are playing on two different continents in Bombay and Chennai. That's been the most that's been one part which has been very different, because the league format has been such that every day you are used to seeing different venues. Now we are just seeing matches happening. You remember the World Cup happened in Australia and New Zealand at one point of time, where conditions were totally different. Ground conditions, etc. So I'm getting that feeling. Yeah, so that's been the most significant aspect for me.
Perfect. Let's go to our stats, man. We've got Arun right here. Arun, any hangover to the show? And also the most surprising thing for the week gone by?
Hangover is not really, but you know what? I was actually looking at social media and keeping an eye, because I didn't want anything I said to be interpreted in a controversial manner. You know, things we spoke about, KL, Rahul, Virat Kohli, I said, okay, and no controversy, I said, yeah.
Yes. So we say it's smooth, basically, but I'm not sure. Smooth. How do we promise that after this show, though?
We'll see. Nothing controversial. We won't promise that, but yeah, we tried not to be controversial. Surprising thing for me, Kane Williamson played.
Oh!
I thought they pinned it down that you'll only be part of the team and you'll keep encouraging people, encouraging the players. How did he play? And they won that game.
They won that game. I think that was the most shocking thing of the week, for sure. For sure. Alright, so what are we waiting for? Let's just start with the segment, TV Empire. Can we have the front foot, please? Well, for all those who are tuning in for the first time, let me just explain what we do right here. So, you know, the Indian T20 League is so colourful. It's got the oranges, and it's got the reds, and it's got the yellows, it's got the blues, and you name it. So what we do is that we pick the best colour that suits us, which means we take the top three, you know, like something that has been trending on social media or has made news or the most talked about topic, and we discuss it right here. So we start with number three. And number three pe hai Bangalore. And of course, the tagline is Sala Kab Naam De.
No. Sorry. They are number four. They are four from four. They are not number three.
Well, they better not be anywhere around number three is what they kind of want that. So on a roll is Bangalore. Four out of four. They've had four wins out of four matches. This is the most rocking start they've had to an Indian T20 League season. I mean, 2016, which was known to be their dream season, they'd lost two there. So Arun, when does a Bangalore fan go like, chalo bhai, ye toh humara hai, ye kahin nahi ja raha? When does that happen?
Never. Not till Virat Kohli lifts that trophy, you know. Never till he lifts the cup like this. I don't think Bangalore fans are. Virat Kohli himself is not celebrating. You know, I was glad Harsha, I think it was Harsha who asked Virat Kohli to speak to his fans the other night. And Virat Kohli said, we're not overly excited. It's like, again, this entire week didn't happen. Last week we spoke about it, where Virat Kohli had said, we're not over excited about our wins. Two wins later, 1 week later, he mentioned exactly the same thing. So while I think what Bangalore are doing is they're being guarded in terms of what's happening. They know that this is a competitive league and things can just change very quickly. So I don't think at any point in time, neither are RCB, Bangalore within the dressing room themselves saying this time the cup is ours, nor are Bangalore fans.
Bangalore fans, I mean, I saw Kohli do that in the presentation again, you know, Akhil, that just chill, don't get excited, don't jinx it. It's amazing how they're playing this. But the thing is that what do they do? Like, particles clicking, right? Their death bowling's clicking. Give me one thing that's not clicking for Bangalore, according to you.
Maybe the number 3 spot, that's the only spot that they might be a little worried about, because that's something that they've not yet sealed in on. But see, I've led a team from Bengaluru, not as a player, but I mean, I've led one team, and I was also similarly cautious because the Bangalore cricket team was in existence much before we started running the team. And the same vibes used to happen exactly like we are speaking. If we won 3-4 matches in a row, the fans used to start get delirious on social media, and they used to say that while the cricket team cannot win, the Kabaddi team probably will get us a trophy. So we have also been like very guarded. You win 3-4 matches in the beginning of the season, you say you don't want to peak too early. You'd rather win 3-4 matches back to back at the end of the tournament. And Virat is an experienced guy now. He's done enough seasons with the Bangalore team. But I think their marketing machinery needs to just maybe ramp it down a little bit, not go over the top with doing too many interviews with the players and too much inside content. Now they've won 4, they have a great opportunity to seal a place in the playoff. That is the most crucial part first. First, you get into the playoffs. Don't worry about the last 2 matches. You have enough impact players to win you championships there. First thing is win your 8-9 games that are there. Get your first or second spot. Get yourself a chance in the playoff. That should be the only aim now.
Let's your guest number 2. What do we have at number 2 this week? Let's take a look. You see, the Indian team has a great headache. The headache is that our openers are who? So that is what is trending on our doubtful review system on number 2. There you go. We've got the karta dharta of the Indian team right here. The question is, World Cup mein mere saath kaun open karega? Kohli is asking that. And Ravi Shastri is like, good question. If I ask the same thing, you guys are going to give me the same response. Like, a good question. It's a good question. I'll start. Yeah, go for it, Akhil.
I think Ravi bhai should be asking that question to Rohit, isn't it? Rohit should be asking that question rather, because he is penciled in as India's number 1 opener in white ball cricket. So he should be the one who should be asking, mere saath open kaun karega? And secretly, I think they should also let Rohit Sharma pick. There should be like a chit, you know. There was a nice story that Sachin and Sehwag had said about the 2003 World Cup, where they said that there was a team meeting and they had to decide who's going to open with Sachin, who's going to open with Sehwag in the right. World Cup. And the team management had a meeting and it was between Tendulkar and Ganguly. So everybody was supposed to put in a chit and say that who they are supposed to have as an opening partner. And out of everyone, there was only one chit which said about that Ganguly should open. The rest of them all wanted Sachin to open. So I think to answer your question, that is how the Indian team management should do now, also get like an opinion thing from inside the thing. And I think the rest of them should, Rohit should have a bigger vote in saying that who should open with him.
That's fantastic. Thank you for sharing that with us. But then the problem is bigger than that, you know, because see, looking beyond Rohit Sharma is like looking beyond butter naan in a buffet. So you can't look beyond him. Alright, but there are options like Sanju Samson. Alright, then Mr. Kohli himself has announced that I want to be opening for Bangalore this season is because he's probably getting insecure to your opening spot. It's a joke, guys. It's a joke. It's a joke. It's a joke.
I'm laughing.
JOK in caps, in all bold, in red letter, red colored font. Yes.
Right, and then you've got a Shikhar Dhawan. You got some Delhi players who look great as openers. You got a Prithvi Shaw, you got Shikhar Dhawan. You got KL Rahul, exactly. So, what do the numbers say, Arun?
We are having this debate and I think it's pointless. I think Ravi Shastri, Virat Kohli and Rohit Sharma have sat down. They must have sat down over a drink or a lunch or a meal or whatever. And they must have said, okay, कोई कुछ भी बोले विराट कोहली रोहित शर्मा टू ओपन फॉर द नेक्स्ट सिक्स मंथ्स व्हिच मींस द वर्ल्ड कप टी20 इज कवर्ड. I'd love KL Rahul to open with Rohit Sharma at the top. Akhil and I spoke about this a couple of days ago. I think if you looked at India's T20 batsmen, right? KL Rahul and Rohit Sharma would be your top two. Virat Kohli would probably come a number three or a number four, but it's Rohit Sharma and KL Rahul for me, and that's penciled in, sealed, cemented, done.
Perfect. Alright, as long as we settle that debate right here on the Doubtful Review system, we don't have a doubt about that. Moving on to number one. What is trending on number one of the show for this particular week? But on number one, we have that does anything really change in the Indian T20 League? The Indian T20 League has not changed much since its inception, then and now. Alright, gentlemen, of course, there are so many things like Harbhajan is still playing, you know. Hyderabad is still trying to figure the playing 11. There are so many things. So I'll start with your. What do you think has not changed in the Indian T20 League?
Tony's reading of the game. There was that one particular incident the other day when he said, dry ball ghumega, I think, or something like that.
Yeah.
I'm a huge fan, which is well documented. So for me, that was the moment of this. I mean, this guy's reading of the game is phenomenal. He's a genius at understanding angles, understanding moments when he needs to pounce on. He'll wait. He'll wait, and then pounce on things. So, Dhoni for me.
Razor sharp. What about you, Akhil?
Oh, well, I mean, the growth of the league is unprecedented in terms of any other sporting event in India. Year on year, it's growing. So, that is something which is definitely not changed. Like you mentioned, Harbhajan Singh is still playing, although for a different franchise. Amit Mishra is still playing, he's still taking wickets
season
one, which is still not changed. The team which used to not do well and which is now like the dominating team in the league, that is one thing which has changed. So the one thing again we are missing big time and which is not the same is crowds. The kind of euphoria that used to happen in grounds in India just to get one seat for a match in India, that love and that thing that is missing, but hopefully the next season.
But having said that, the cameramen still manage to find pretty girls. Even when there is no crowd, they still have the camera on a pretty girl. How do they do that?
look, what's the IPL without all the glamour, all the big bucks, all the razzmatazz, all the noise, all the hype? If you talk about it, that's what makes this league the grandest league in the world. So yeah.
Alright, perfect, beautiful. Well, that wraps up Front Foot Please. With that, let's shift gears to the segment where we love to put our guests, our experts, the two batsmen who are literally clicking on the spot. So this is called the Hotspot. Alright gentlemen, you know the drill, it's very simple. I'm going to give you guys a scenario, a situation, and I just want to know how would you react to that. So I'm going to start with you, Arun, and here is what I have for this week. So the scenario goes like, you are AB de Villiers and you have to choose between spending time with Baby de Villiers and playing the World T20 this year. What would you do? That is the question. This is a really tough question.
And you know my answer, but if I were AB de Villiers, I would want to play in that World Cup, which I've already announced to the world. I need to win that one trophy.
Yeah.
I need a World Cup in my resume. That's the one thing that's lacking. I may be a billionaire, I may be a millionaire, I may be the world's best T20 player, but I do not have a trophy and I want that.
Perfect. All right. So if you were ABD, you were playing that game. All right. We've got this one for you, Akhil. You are Sanju Samson. Every T20 season, you start off with a bang. And everyone wonders why you're not a Team India regular, but then your form dips like the economy after a pandemic. What do you tell yourself in the mirror?
Oh, this is an interesting one. I tell myself, need to find the consistency, need to get the mental space right. That's the only thing. I shouldn't be worried about the spot in the Indian team. Get my consistency, the team spot in the Indian team will follow. But also, I think he should just learn to enjoy his game a little bit. Looking at him from the outside, seems like he's an overthinker. Like, he thinks too much about different aspects. Maybe he just needs to find a space. You know, Rahul Bhai used to always say in interviews that after a point of time, you need to stop thinking too much about it. I think that's where he should just calm down.
Who, Rahul Bhai? Because he's not Rahul calming down. So, calming and Rahul Bhai don't go together anymore. Having said that, with that, well played, guys. Well done out there. Let's move on to our next segment, which is Three Reds or Empire Score. Well, you know this one. You know, in the DRS, in the original DRS, is always this element of doubt. But on this particular show, I'm going to put you on the spot again and again. So this is what we're going to do here. Alright, so this is a different game. I'm sure you guys have used a dating app, and I'm just going to say it without even knowing whether you've used it. It's very simple. You either swipe left or you swipe right. So that's what we're going to do. We are inches away from the mega auction. So, I'm going to give you some players from each team. So, I'm going to give you three players. And you have to tell me whether you swipe left or swipe right. So, the very first one we've got from Chennai. Alright, and the three players from Chennai are, here you go, whether you retain or reject. It is Ruturaj Gaikwad, Moin Ali and Suresh Raina. I'll start with you again. Retain who? And if you reject, do you reject all of them?
Retain Gaikwad, reject the rest of them before the auction. In the auction, then you can have a go at getting Moin Ali back. And obviously, it depends on Raina's fitness. You have enough time to see at the auction. But definitely retain Gaikwad and build him as one of your key batsmen.
Alrighty. Yeah, that's a good call. Moving on to the next team that we have. We've got Kolkata coming up. And the three players from Kolkata that you'd want to retain or reject, Arun. Alright, Pat Cummins. We've got Kamlesh and Shubman Gill. Out of the three, who would you retain? And of course, if you had to reject, who would you?
Swipe right on a Gill, which is retain, and reject Cummins and Nagarkoti.
And why is that?
While I've invested in Nagarkoti over these last few years, I haven't seen enough in terms of returns. So I might just release him to see if there are any other picks in the auction. And Pat Cummins, it's had a disappointing IPL, honestly. So yeah, not for me.
And you might just get him back at lesser than a 15-16 crore at the bigger auction.
Yeah. It'll be nice if I let Shubman Gill somehow, you know, I let him know that Arun has swipe-righted you.
Oh, I did not.
That would be a reaction I'd love to see on this show. It's happening on season 3. Reaction to
this. Swipe-retain.
Moving on, very quickly, gentlemen, to Rajasthan. So, Rajasthan it is, Ben Stokes, Jofra Archer and Jos Buttler. Out of the three, who would it be for you?
I'll retain none, maybe Buttler at the most, but definitely not the others. If I'm Rajasthan, I'll build a new squad. It's a big option. You have the opportunity to build a big squad, that's what I do.
Well, all right. So that's a powerful statement. He is not going to retain anyone. All of them rejected. With that, moving on to Punjab very quickly. All right, let's see who we've got from Punjab right here. We've got Arshdeep Singh, we've got KL Rahul, and we've got Nicholas Pura. So, who are you going for? Who are you rejecting? Who are you retaining?
I might lose Nicholas Pura and retain Arshdeep and KL Rahul. KL's an investment. KL's a run getter, so KL will definitely be retained. Arshdeep Singh, because it's Punjab, there's a connect, we're trying to build a brand, so yeah.
Okay, perfect. So Arshdeep, and of course, with the bowling figures that he has in this Indian T20 league for sure. Moving on very quickly to Hyderabad. This is interesting. Do Hyderabad themselves know who they want to retain? Who's the playing 11? I think they should just go to people who play a lot of fantasy and just ask them. Ki kisko khilaye? Because they know it better. Alright, very quickly, Rakhil, we've got here are options. Who do you want to retain? Who do you want to reject?
Well, Abdul Samad and Abhishek Sharma will be retained at a much lesser value than the regular capped Indian players. So, depending on the rule, these are the two I would still keep. And yeah, I mean, their biggest retention is obviously going to be their captain from Australia. him and Williamson and Bhuvaneshwar. So they'll be the retention. And Abhishek Samad at a lower price, if possible, then yeah, those two.
Okay, all right, moving on. You got Delhi. Delhi coming your way. So from Delhi, who do you retain? Who do you let go? Kaneza, Rabada, Andrek Norke, and of course, Ishan Sharma. This one's a tough one.
Easy. Reject all.
Really? Okay. And why is that? Why not a Norkia? Wouldn't you give him another chance?
He's bowled well, yes, but I might just get better bowlers of the option next year. So yeah, I might just, if not, I'll buy him back if he comes up.
All right. So that's Delhi. We wrap up Delhi. We move on to Bangalore. And Akhil, this one's for you. Kohli, ABD, or Harshal Patel? Who do you reject? Who do you retain?
So I don't. If I say don't retain a Virat and a De Villiers, I think then there will be people outside our homes and starting to call us names. So obviously.
But that's the thing. You can only retain one person. You can only retain one person. That's the rule.
Oh, is that so?
Yes.
Okay, so obviously they're going to retain the biggest cricketer in India, in the world right now, Virat Kohli.
Okay, alright. So, all you ABD fans, just know what Akhil just said. Alright, this is going to be in headlines tomorrow. Anyway, moving on very quickly. Moving on to the next team that we have, which is the champions, Mumbai. So, Mumbai mein se aap isko retain karenge, aapke paas options hai Jasprit Bumrah.
You have given me an option of retaining between Virat and AB, and there is no Rohit here.
What can I say? It looks like the team loves Arun. They want to make it very, very simple. Alright, so Ishan Kishan, Jasprit Bumrah, Karan Pollard.
It's as simple, isn't it? Straightforward. Bumrah to be retained and Pollard bye-bye, thank you. Ishan Kishan, we'll buy back.
Okay, perfect. Alright, gentlemen, well played there. This was quite the speed dating that I witnessed on this show. And with that, we move on to the next segment of this particular game, where this is like a rapid fire. And what we do here is that, of course, we're very well versed with our filters that we use on our social media, which is Instagram and Snapchat. So I'm going to ask you which filter. So you've got Akhil already nodding his head. It's like, I'm out of this game. I don't know which filter to pick. Alright, it's very simple. With considering their abilities, what are the kind of filters that you would assign to these players? That's the question. Alright, so very first out there, the very first player, and this one I'll start with you all. We've got Virat Kohli that Akhil has retained. Very kindly so. What is the filter that suits the man?
Is there a monk filter available somewhere?
There is a monk filter.
There is, so that's for him. The monk filter.
Alright, think like a monk. It's got that think like a monk thing. Okay, cool. So you've got a think like a monk filter on Virat Kohli. So moving on very quickly to Akhil. So what does that monk filter actually do is that it gives out an advice. So what do you think would be Kohli's advice?
Call tails to win tosses.
Oh! Alright, next one coming for you, Akhil. We've got Chris Gayle coming up next. What is the filter that suits the man?
Chris Gayle has to have a party filter, isn't it? He's such a party animal, he has to have that party filter.
Yeah, party filter suits him, or a boss filter. Like universe boss. Even that suits him really well. Party filter goes well, alright. Party filter assigned to Mr. Gayle, moving on to Ravindra Jadeja. Sir Jadeja, what filter suits the man? Very easy, this is the easiest.
Yeah, it's own filter, it's simple. Or a rocket hitting a stump. Or a rocket.
Of course, and his four catches this week, man. This has been incredible to watch the man. Feel the way he has been. Alright, moving on very quickly to Mr. Pandya. Hardik Pandya. Akhil, what suits Hardik Pandya?
He's like a lifestyle guru, you know. He's become like a lifestyle guru where the kind of clothes he wears. Actually, we should give him a Caribbean filter because I know he loves the West Indians and he loves their philosophy of life. So let's give him a nice Caribbean filter. He's dresses up like them, has chains like them, and like he really likes them. So yeah, that's the filter.
Like you'd like to see him like a Dwayne Bravo kind of mood.
He's exactly that's, like that. He is a he's Hardik Pandya from Barbados.
Alright, I like this one. Moving on. Next is Kane Williamson. That Arun was really excited to see this week.
What do I give Kane? He's such a good boy, yeah. So it got to be. Do we give him a Tauranga ka gunda hume?
Tauranga
ka gunda.
It'd be fun to see that. I hope people are listening to this one.
Tauranga ka gunda.
Yeah. Nice. I like it. All right, moving on to the last one that we have here. We got Dinesh Karthik. And that's for you, Akhil. Dinesh Karthik or Conservative?
Dinesh Karthik ko squash ka filter de de.
I see what you did there.
He should be playing squash regularly outside when he's not playing cricket. So, koi squash ka filter de sakte hai usko.
Okay. Fair deal. And ye to hamare teaser mein jana chahiye. Dinesh Karthik ko squash ka filter do. Ye hamara teaser bana diya aapne show ka. Alright, well that brings me to the end of Three Reds and a Bias Call. And like as usual, this is the reason why I don't have the job of an umpire. Because you see, I'm such a kind and a generous person. And I cannot distinguish between the two apple of my eye on the show of both of you performing so well that I'm actually going to tweet it separately. I'm going to tweet it, I think, on this show. I think both of you did really phenomenally well, but I'm actually going to make a call after the next segment, which is this very interesting segment, but of course we know that you know, in the T20 league, there are so many memes. There are so many things that's made fun of. So I'm going to show you a couple of memes. And I want all of you, both of you, to hold your poker face. You don't have to let go. I'm going to judge whether anybody's giving any kind of expression right now. I have to give any expression. So I'm not playing this, but it's just the two of you.
Okay. So here you go.
So this basically competition as to who holds the poker face, right? So the first one coming your way. Jen, are you ready? Ta-dam! Sam Curran after taking Andre Russell's wicket. No effect? Alright, no effect on our guys here. Moving on to the next one that we have. Next one. Arun, you've like kept a smile on anyway. Okay, so this is it. SR Chonia, the pretty girl the cameraman spotted. Rasaj winning a comfortable game. Nah, no reaction. Alright, moving on. No reaction. This is not taking any bones. This one. Nicholas Puran, brother of Shai the Freebie.
Shahin
Afridi
is going to be related to Shai Afridi.
That,
eh? So, this is nice.
But that's all the reaction that I get out of you?
Yeah. What else do
you okay. Know? Okay. Yeah, that's true. Alright, so nothing's happening, guys. Moving on. Masters of leg break bowling. Okay, moving on, guys. ये मीन्स वालों की तो दुकान बंद करा दोगे आप लोग KKR fans टारगेट 153 KKR 31/30 with 6 wickets in hand MI 1/10 runs no
अब तो आदत सी पड़ गई है दैट इज द सॉन्ग दैट शुड बी प्लेड
ऑलराइट guess. Do we have another one? No, I think we're running out of stock now. We don't have any more memes. What, you guys are really good at this game? Now. Not even yet.
What you did not see was me holding my wrist hard. I was clenching my fingers because I wanted the price. I was
so like,
I was like this. Come on, Arun, poker face.
But which one was the one that you found the coolest?
The last one. Absolutely the last one. KKR.
I think KKR just stole the show. Also the Sam Curran one. I think Sam Curran was also pretty cool.
It was cool, yeah.
But thank you, gentlemen. Thanks a lot. This has been a great, great day and a great start of my day. So thank you for doing this and for all the fun and laughter. You guys have to stay tuned to the Dark Review System.
Yes, you will privately tell us who the winner is. Who gets to
have her?
She's
going to tweet it. See, the world is watching.
On the
bed. Okay, had fun?
Had fun, yes, absolutely. As we will, we have fun on this show and get to see a different side of cricket also. So, always fun.
Alright, Arun, I'm going to see you later very soon. I hope you had a blast. And more importantly, stay safe, guys. Wear a mask. Everybody who's watching, wear a mask. Stay home. This is the best you can do. And of course, stay tuned to the Dark Review System. We will see you next week very soon.